Now in today's class, we will start with exercise 2.7, question number 3. Now in our previous classes, you have learned how to rationalize the denominator. How will you rationalize? By taking the conjugate of the denominator. Suppose if it is root 2 minus 5, up and down you will multiply by root 2 plus 5. Okay, that is change the symbol. That is called conjugate. So here you have third one, find the value of a and b if root 7 minus 2 by root 7 plus 2 equals a root 7 plus b. So here again what we will do, the left hand side we will rationalize. When we rationalize the left hand side, what you will get? Root 7 minus 2 into root 7 minus 2 divided by root 7 plus 2 root 7 minus 2. Okay, this is plus 2, you have to multiply up and down by minus 2. So here on the numerator you will get a minus b whole square, a square minus 2ab plus b square. And when you square the root thing, it will become 7. Okay, root 7 whole square is 7. So 7 minus 4 root 7 plus 4 divided by 3. So this will give you 11 minus 4 root 7 divided by 3. So here what we will do, we will separate it as fractions. This common denominator we will take 11 by 3 minus 4 by 3 root 7. Okay, the full denominator separated for 11 and separated for minus 4 root 7. Now what we will do, this whatever answer we got, this we will compare it with a root 7 plus b. Okay, when we compare it with a root 7 plus b, what will be our a value? That is the coefficient of root 7. Now what is the coefficient of root 7 here? Minus 4 by 3. So your a value will be minus 4 by 3. And your b value will be the constant, that is 11 by 3. Okay, this is how you will do this sum. Now the next one, what they have given, fourth one. The fourth one they have given, if x equals root 5 plus 2, then find the value of x square plus 1 by x square. Okay, so first what we will do, we will write the x value given, then we will do what is 1 by x. Okay. So first, x value they have given is root 5 plus 2. So 1 by x will be 1 by root 5 plus 2. Now what you have to do? Up and down you have to multiply by root 5 minus 2. So this will be root 5 plus 2 into root 5 minus 2 and up also root 5 minus 2. So denominator is of the form a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square. So you will get root 5 the whole square minus 4. What is root 5 the whole square? 5. So 5 minus 4 will give you 1. That is root 5 minus 2 by 1, which is same as root 5 minus 2. Okay, so 1 by x value we are getting root 5 minus 2. And x value is root 5 plus 2. Okay, now next what we will do? We will do what is x plus 1 by x. Okay, we will do what is x plus 1 by x. So that is root 5 plus 2 plus root 5 minus 2. Okay, x value is root 5 plus 2. This is root 5 minus 2. So what will happen? 2 and minus 2 will get cancelled. Root 5 plus root 5 is 2 root 5. Okay, root 5 plus root 5 is 2 root 5. Now what we have to find actually, we have to find the value of x square plus 1 by x square. Okay, so what you will do, x plus 1 by x the whole square. Okay, first you do what is x plus 1 by x the whole square. That answer will give you 2 root 5 the whole square. 2 root 5 the whole square will be 2 square into root 5 whole square. What is 2 square? 4. What is root 5 whole square? 5. So 4 into 5 what you will get? 20. Okay, so this will give you 20. So x plus 1 by x the whole square answer is 20. Okay, now the next thing after this what you write is, see, what is x plus 1 by x the whole square? That is a plus b the whole square. Okay, a plus b the whole square formula you use, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Clear? A square plus 2ab plus b square. Now when you are doing 2ab, what will happen? This x and 1 by x will get cancelled. Okay, x and 1 by x will get cancelled. So left hand side what you will get? X square plus 2 plus 1 by x square. And what you have to do for the 2? That 2 you have to transpose to right hand side. So this will give you x square plus 1 by x square equals to 20 minus 2. So that is x square plus 1 by x square equals 18. So after this, please write the step. Okay, x plus 1 by x whole square only we got, no? What we have to find is x square plus 1 by x square. So that will give you 20 minus 2, that equals 18. Okay, this is how you will do the fourth one. Now the fifth one you have is, root 2 value is given to you, 1.414. Find the value of 8 minus 5 root 2 divided by 3 minus 2 root 2. Okay, you have to find till 3 decimal places. So, the first thing as usual, what we will do, we will rationalize the denominator. So, what we will get, this will be 8 minus 5 root 2 into 3 plus 2 root 2 divided by, your minus is there, we multiply up and down by plus. So, this will give you 24. Okay, a plus, but this is this one, distributive property you use. That is 8 into 3 is 24, 8 into 2 is 16 root 2, and this will give you minus 15 root 2, minus into plus is minus, 5 into 2 is 10, and root 2 into root 2 is 2. So 10 into 2 will give you 20, divided by 3 square minus 2 root 2 the whole square. So here you will get, 24 minus 20 is 4. 4 plus root 2 divided by 1. And then what's the root 2 value they've given? 1.414. So 4 plus 1.414. So you add both. 4 is 4.0. 4.0 plus 1.414 will give you 5.414. So this is how you will do the fifth one. Okay, the root 2 value is given and you need to find the value of 8 minus 5 root 2 divided by 3 minus 2 root 2. Now the next thing what you have is scientific notation. Where we use the scientific notation for representing big numbers, we use the scientific notation. It's a very easy exercise, okay? Now see, directly we will start with the exercise, okay? It's very easy. Now, here you have the first, just count the number of zeros properly, okay? Exercise 2.8, the first one, represent the following numbers in scientific notation. So, what we have to do is, after the first digit, you need to put the decimal point. Okay, after the first digit, you need to put the decimal point. So, now see, after the first digit, when you are putting the decimal point, now see, after first digit, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. After the first digit, you have 11 digits. So you will write 5.6943 into 10 power 11. Okay, just count number of digits after the first digit and that much will be the power. So the answer will be 5.6943 into 10 power 11. Now the next one what you have is 2000.57. Okay, 2000.57. So, now in this C, what you are doing, again you have to put the decimal point after the first digit. Now already the decimal point is here. So, how many places it's shifting? It's shifting to 3 decimal places. So, this will be 2.00057 into 10 cube. Okay. See, they have given the example sums. You can see that also. Okay. They have given the example sums. You can see that also. See, like this one. The third one, when you see the example sum, the decimal point, see how many places it's shifting. You count that and that much will be the power. Okay. The same type only you have to do the exercise sums. Now the next one what you have is 0.00000600000. Now in this case, when you see which side the decimal point is moving, the decimal point is shifting to your right hand side. Now whenever the decimal point is shifting to your right hand side, the power will be negative. When the decimal point is shifting to your left hand side, the power will be positive. Keep that in mind. So here, now how many places it's shifting we'll see. Okay, see after the first whole number part, that is this one, 6, you have to put the decimal point. So shift it, how many jumps we will see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 jumps it is going to your left hand side. Sorry, 7 jumps it's going to the right hand side. Okay, 7 jumps, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is reaching here. 7 jumps it's going to the right hand side. So what you will do? You will put the power as negative. So this will be 6.000 into 10 power minus 7. Or you can write 6.0 into 10 power minus 7. Okay. So when the decimal digit is moving to your right hand side, the power is negative. When the decimal point is shifting to your left hand side, the power is positive. Keep that in mind for doing these sums. Now the fourth one again you have. See, fourth one also you have to shift it to the right hand side. That is, you have to put the decimal point after 9. So this will give you 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will give you 9.0 into 10 power minus 4. Because it's shifting to 4 places. Okay, you can with pencil you can put the arrow mark. This is first jump, second jump, third jump and fourth jump. Okay, since the decimal point is shifting to your right hand side, the power will be negative. So 9.0 into 10 power minus 4. Now the second Roman letter you have. Write the following numbers in decimal form. Okay, write the following numbers in decimal form. That is, first number given is 3.459 into 10 power 6. That is what you have to do. You have to remove this power. Okay, you have to remove the power. That is what you will do. How many zeros you will put here? 6 zeros you will put. Okay, 6 zeros you will put and then you will put the decimal point. So, after putting 6 zeros, what you will get? You will get 3459. Okay. 3, the decimal point will go off. 3459, 0, 0, 0, 0, 6 zeros will come. And then how many decimal digits you have to put? 1, 2, 3. 3 decimal digits you have to put. So, this will be 3459, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So, first, when you are multiplying with decimal numbers, what you will do? Without decimal point only, you will multiply, no? So, this is 3.459 into 10 power 6. What you will do? 3, 4, 5, 9 and 6 zeros you will put. And then you have 3 decimal digits here. So, put the 3 decimal digits so that zeros will go off. So, the answer will be 3459000. That will be the answer. Now the second one you have, is 5.678 into 10 power 4. So again, 5.678, how will you write? 5, 6, 7, 8 and 4 zeros. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 4 zeros. This is 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now how many decimal digits are there? 1, 2, 3. So from here you put 1, 2, 3. So this decimal point will come over here. So the answer will be 5, 7, 6, 8, 0. Okay. The answer will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 0. Now the next one. Third one you have, third one they have given 1.00005 into 10 power minus 5. So again you do the same thing. Now see, the power is negative here. Since the power is negative, where the decimal point will go, the decimal point will shift to the right hand side. Okay, the decimal point will shift to your right hand side. So you will get, this will be 0.00001 0005. Okay, this is how you will get for third one. Now the fourth one you have 2.53009 × 10⁻⁷. So again you shift it. Okay, since the power is negative, it will be shifted to the right hand side. So you will get the answer 0.12345625300. Okay, this is how you will do the fourth one. Whenever the negative power is there, shift it to right hand side. Whenever positive power is there, shift it to left hand side. So this completes your exercise 2.8, second Roman letter. Now your homework for today is, do this one. See, the example 2.27. Example 2.27, first one and second one. And then 2.7 exercise, third and fourth one, do it again in your homework notebook. Okay, already you have written the classwork, no? Do it again in your homework notebook. So, four sums you have, exercise 2.7, question number 3, question number 4, and exercise 2.27, first one and second one.